Hi, this time, we are going to make a dissolve area. First, create a material parameter collection to be applied to material and blueprint, and then click to open the window. Click twice adds element in vector parameter to create two parameters. As in the video, open the detailed information of the parameter and set the names as location and scale, respectively. We will use this parameter to set the material and use it in blueprint. Next, create a material and click on it to open the window. By setting the material's blend mode to masked, you can make certain parts of the material transparent. Next, drag and drop the previously created material parameter collection into the material window to create two. Now name the parameter names of MPCs to location and scale. Next, we will create a box mask 3D node which can draw a box in 3D space. Next, create an absolute world position node and connect it to the box mask 3D node to get world coordinates. Parameter collection is in float 4 format and does not require alpha values, so create two component masks, check R, G, and B values, and connect each of them to parameter collections to extract only R, G, and B values. Next, click while holding down the M button on the keyboard to create a multiply node. And hold down the S button and click to create a parameter node, then set the parameter value. Now, if you connect nodes like the video, you can adjust the size of the box space with parameters. For the next step, create one more parameter node which is for adjusting the thickness of the edges of the box space. Now, connect the nodes we have connected so far to the box mask node. Create a 1- node and connect it to the box mask node. When you connect the 1- node to the opacity mask, only the space specified as the box mask becomes transparent. Finally, hold down 3 on the keyboard and click to create a constant 3 vector node. If you want to change the color with an instance, you can convert it with a parameter. After selecting the desired color, connect it to the base color node of the material to determine the background color of the material. Now save and exit to the content browser. Next, place the cube mesh actor of place actors into the level. Then click Blueprint Add Script in the details of the created actor to create a blueprint. Open Blueprint's construction script window to set the material's parameter value. Next, create and connect two set vector parameter value nodes. Set the previously created parameter collection and set location and scale to parameter name, respectively. Next, drag a mesh component from the component list to create a getWorldLocation node and a getWorldScale node and connect them to the mesh component. Now, when you connect nodes, as in the video, the location and size of the mesh placed in the world are received to determine the location and size of the materials box mask. After checking everything is done, compile. Finally, in order not to render every time, set mobility as movable in the details of the mesh component. Now, set the scale of the cube as bigger and wider and place it on the level. Next, right-click on the previously created material to create an instance, then apply it to the cube you just placed. Even if you put the cube made of blueprint into the cube with which the material was set, it is hard to figure out whether it goes transparent or not right away. So, to make the cube made of blueprint transparent, create a material and open a window. Set the material's blend mode to translucent. And then, hold down the one key on the keyboard and click to create a constant node and connect it to opacity with 0 as it is to make the material transparent. Now, when you apply the material you just created to blueprint and move, you can see that it becomes transparent as much as the box space.